Good afternoon, folks. Grandpa Greenwald here. Today we're going to make some chicken bratwurst. And we're going to do a little bit, it's going to be a little bit different. We need to add lots of fat. The chicken comes with basically no fat in it. So we're going to have to add our 30%, at least 30% pork fat to our mixture. And that's going to require, you know, all of this requires the meat to be frozen or close to frozen, so it'll go through the grinder real easy, and the chicken, you know, is a nice soft thing anyway, so it's a little bit more difficult. So I've been working for days now trying to get these pieces cut up, get them partially frozen, not too frozen. I have more in the freezer. I have the chicken breasts in the freezer. It's been a trying time here, waiting on the post office since Saturday to bring my new bratwurst spices. Go figure, we don't have them. So we're going to get started and go ahead and get this stuff ground at least. So I don't need to keep taking it in and taking it out, those type of things. So let's get started. Wish us luck. Hip. Nip. We locked up. That's a good one. So we got a cold plate. Trying to pull this grinder also into just spitting this out. Spitting it out through the small hole plate. Apparently we froze in there. Sure enough. So I think we're gonna have to. Wow, that was way too cold to do what we were trying to do. So let's go ahead and regroup with that. These are the kind of things that happen, especially when you're, maybe not in, this is not exactly unfamiliar territory, it's been a while. I was prepared. I do have my large plate and my knife ready to go, so regroup here. All right. I'm trying to avoid grinding it twice. That was a failure. I might have to let this thaw out a little bit. We struggled through on the getting the frozen fat ground, and now we're doing the second grind in it out of it. Looking like spaghetti. I'm kind of trying to get this reground again while it's still real, real cold, so it'll just fall through the grinder. Sticky. This ground is really, really nice a second. You can see in there, it's just really a beautiful brine. This is all just pure fat, so we're going to be adding the chicken to it. I'm going to take this out of here, put it in the fridge, keep this just as cold as it is now, see if we get the chicken ground, then we'll go back and start over again, mixing the chicken and the correct amount of pork in the. If my casings and my new spices ever show up, we're gonna get this mixed today. Alrighty, we got the chicken thawed out just a little bit. We're gonna see if we can put some of this through there and see where we end up. Alrighty then, we have the chicken ground, we have the pork fat ground and in the fridge. In a minute, we're gonna bring them out and blend them. In the meantime, I'm gonna clean this little bit of a mess up. We started out kind of slow with the grinder jam and the frozen pork, but boy, oh boy, it ended really, really nice here. So we'll be back in just a minute. £10, £8. £10, £8. I have 3.5 pounds of pork fat. Put a lot of pork fat in there. We're going to compensate for some of the lack of fat in the chicken. To be nice and juicy. In this sausage, we're going to use a binder. It's a sodium phosphate powder. And what we're going to put in is 3.5, we're going to cool water, 3.5 teaspoons. I'm going to put a big one, and that'll make it 3.5 teaspoons right out, spot on. With 8 ounces of water. The water is not significant, so I know that I'm going to need, some added water to this, so get this dissolved real good. The other thing that this phosphate does, and I'm not an expert on this at all, but from what I understand, this phosphate also acts as a helps the sausage to retain the water. And we know there's lots of water, lots of moisture in the chicken breasts naturally, and we're going to help the sausage to retain that water, bind real well with the fat that we added to the chicken sausage, and just make a really, really nice, really make a nice sausage. Lost my words there, I'd tell you better, but we'll get back to that. A little bit left in the sausage. So I've been bouncing this around. It's a little kind of tough to see what's chicken and what's fat. Actually, it's not tough, it's impossible to see what's chicken and what's fat. But that's okay when we get done. Well, this is nice and really nice and cold the way it's supposed to be. We're gonna mix it. We're gonna mix it real good. We want it sticky, sticky, sticky. You guys ready to get started again? Let's see if I can untangle some of these casings here. I'm ready to go. I have the hopper already filled. We have 14 pounds of sausage in there. You see how cold it is? It's frosting over a little bit, not frosting, but it's showing the cold. You tell I've been in Texas a long time, I don't even know what that's called. Anyway, the sausage is probably the gooeyest sausage I've ever made in my life. It's really sticky, and I did mix it a bunch more. I did not add any additional water. It had plenty of water that came with the chicken. We did add some extra spice to kind of compensate for some of that extra, even though it's in the weight. This baby is not on there. Right. Okay. That's what happens. We got 15 pounds of sausage in there. Easy fix. I believe it to be an easy fix if we don't do something not so smart. Okay, lift that up. Put it back together from this side. I guess it'll work from either side, but that kind of freaked me out because I'm right-handed and I'm used to seeing things and operating things a certain way. So we're just going to move down to the color of the eye. Here we go. God, those are working real good. They're easy to... There's a busted casing there, though. So, let's Let's not worry about that so much. I'm gonna go ahead and link this one. We'll worry about that later. Huh. There's another busted case, and that's really, really not, hasn't been an occurrence with us. Making sausage, but we can fix it. Doing on this, I think we talked about this before, that we're just getting our, we're skipping this one and creating a link after it, which creates the link there. Piece of cake. Kind of get a little muscle memory, you get them real close to the same size. The sausage is really, really glue gooey, so I haven't learned how to do the flippity thing like that, but we don't have this to, I guess we could try to roll it some kind of way. I'll take it flipping. We can do that. Tomatoes, this is the fun part here. I got a break here. I'm just going to take those out and stuff them in the new. There you go. Not too shabby. So I intended, also, I bought some 32 millimeter collagen casings. I wanted to try stuffing that into collagen. Collagen, nice edible casing. Something that you would find maybe on a snack stick or something like that. So they are edible. They give you a nice crunch when you bite into it. One of the issues with making brats with it or making a sausage with it is that they don't link very well or hold their link very well. So it's very common for people to tie them. So that's two ties in between each sausage. I wasn't in for it today. I couldn't make that investment. All right, got about maybe 14 more sausages. Let's see. Sausages. That's it. Thank you. And kind of looking at these, it doesn't really look like we have that much pricking to do in these. That's part of making a nice, kind of a nice mushy, not mushy, it's just gonna be a great sausage, but making a nice sausage like this, it fills the casings really nice. We tend not to have as many air pockets. So, there's a lesson in itself there that things don't always have to look perfect, and you're just doing your best. Look at that. There's one there, and that one looks like it needs to be linked. So let's go ahead and link it. It was already partially linked. And then the last one. All right, we're gonna get these. And get these over here. We want them to. We do want that them to be able to dry out, the casings to dry out. We'll put the phosphate in. But you see how wet these sausages are. So we're losing a lot of that natural water from the chicken. But we put that extra additional water in. We have a little extra fat in them. I think these are going to be nice and juicy. And if they're not, we're going to enjoy them anyway. All right, I think we're done for right now. Blue ribbon chicken bratwurst. Blue ribbon bratwurst. Chicken and pork. Blue ribbon chicken bratwurst.